Good Thursday, Longhorns. Today is February 21st, 2019. Coming up on this week's broadcast are Lady Longhorns Make History. We'll tell you how and all that and more, so let's get started. Good Thursday, I'm Andrea Quiroz. Thank you for making us a part of your day. This is what's happening in Longhorn Nation. Attention sophomore and junior students, if you are interested in taking college-level courses during your high school career, you need to take the TSI. Our counseling center is offering the TSI test on March 1st. You can still register and pay at the counseling center. Please register soon because there are limited spaces available. To those students who have already picked up the application for the Border Explorers, your recruitment night will be on March 8th. Please make plans to attend and submit your applications as soon as possible. Just a reminder to those graduates who will be signing with the U.S. military, please be sure to visit Ms. Martinez to be recognized at graduation. For more information, please visit Ms. Martinez in the Counseling Center. Also, any seniors who have 4 years of perfect attendance, please visit Ms. Martinez so you can be recognized at graduation as well. Would you or someone you know like to be a tutor? Our NHS peer tutoring started this past Wednesday and will be continuing until further notice, every Wednesday. Tutoring will be on any subject as well as AP exams, SAT, and ACT exams. If you are interested, go by E139 with Ms. Arcinaga. To everyone interested, carnival tickets have been sold every day this past week, and today will be the last day. One sheet of 18 tickets is only $8. These will be valid until today, February 21st. Cash, credit, and debit cards are all accepted. Please visit the bookkeeping office for more info. And now with your national news is Ray Robledo.
Longhorns, and my name is Ray, and welcome to the national news. In Aurora, Illinois, a man named Gary Martin took out a pistol in his manufacturing job from which he told he was getting fired from. It was after his termination meeting that he took out his pistol and started firing. Then he went into the warehouse and sought several employees and several responding officers. One employee and five officers were injured. In other news, a zombie deer disease has killed deer and moose in more than 20 states. The chronic wasting disease was first discovered in Colorado in deer in 1981. Many scientists are comparing it to the mad cow disease from the 1990s. There have been no report of human illness due to the disease, and scientists have not have any conclusive evidence that it may harm people. That's it for this week's news. Now, back to you.
And now with your world news is Barbara Mohammed.
Good afternoon, Longhorns. I'm Barbara, and I'll be your world news anchor this semester. Today, Israel is going to be the fourth country to land on the moon with an ultimate spacecraft named Bereshit. This spacecraft weighs about 1,300 pounds and is about 5 feet tall. It will be sent on a 7-week journey to the moon where it will take photos of the surface and will perform experiments. Meanwhile, in Italy, Antonella Bellina, a 39-year-old fashion designer, discovered a way of converting spoiled milk into silk. This woman has a company who collects spare milk from farms and then uses it to make clothing, which looks amazing. She found a way to heat the milk, add acid, and create the fabric to actually put onto t-shirts.
Make, for example, 1 kilo of milk fiber. We just use less than 1 liter of water. So we save a lot of water.
This company is planning on entering the global market this year, so let's mentally adjust to the fact that we won't be necessarily smelling rotten by looking awesome. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye. Now back to you.
With more on your Lady Longhorns advancing to the Sweet 16 is Lisandra Vasquez.
What's up, guys? It's Lisandra Vasquez, and I'm here with your sports news. Starting off with our boys basketball team, who played Monday at Mission, Texas. Our boys won 55-35, and we'll be advancing to the second round of playoffs. Congratulations and good luck. Our girls basketball team played United South Tuesday night. We started off with South scoring a layup, putting them ahead 2 points. Then Evelyn Quiroz shooting a 3-pointer, putting us ahead. Our girls finished the first quarter with Natalia Treviño shooting a layup, putting us 16-10. Second quarter, South shoots a 3-pointer, trying to catch up to our girls, but Ariana Garza passes the ball to Audrey Beatty, who shoots a layup, putting us 18-13. We finished the first quarter with Olivia Campero shooting a layup, putting us ahead 20-16. We then go to third quarter with Audrey Beatty scoring a layup and putting us 32-21, finishing off the third quarter with Olivia Campo putting us ahead 34-21. Our girls played a great game, finishing off their game with a win of 55-43, heading to Sweet 16. First time ever our girls basketball team and volleyball team go to Sweet 16 in the same year. Congratulations, girls, and that's it for our sports news.
Now with our new Longhorn Spotlight is Hugo Gomez and Darío Alcorta.
Good Thursday, Longhorns. I'm Darío Alcorta.
And I'm Hugo Gomez, and we'll be your Longhorn Spotlight anchors for the semester.
We start the semester off highlighting Lindsay Lingreta and Stacey Garcia. Beginning with Lindsay, she is a senior and has been in the Longhorn Lariat for 3 years.
And Stacey Garcia, who's been in Longhorn Lariat for 4 years.
Hi, I'm Lindsay Lingreta.
And I'm Stacey Garcia.
They are both interested in technology and hope to continue furthering this passion in college. Stacey and Lindsay, along with all the Lariats, put in hours of practice all year long to prepare for dance competitions.
And how long have you been in Lariat?
I've been in Lariat for 3 years now. And I've been in Lariat for 4 years.
And how do you plan to make your parents proud?
To excel academically, yes. And live a happy life.
Thank you to Lindsay and Stacey for being this week's Longhorn Spotlight.
And thank you for tuning in this week's Longhorn Spotlight. See you next week.
With your weekly movie review is Marco Cavazos and Ray Rodriguez.
What's up, movie watchers? I'm Marco.
And I'm Ray. This is your Right On Reviews. This week we're going to be talking about How to Train Your Dragon, The Lost World.
This movie is a great end to a trilogy of animated movies. This movie is able to fully satisfy anyone that was a fan of the trilogy. Even newcomers to the movie would be able to enjoy this all on its own. This movie seems to be a good all-around. The animation and artwork looks great, as well as the story is extremely good at grabbing any fun movie watcher's attention.
The movie received an outstanding 94% approval rating on Rotten Tomatoes and a 74% approval rating on IMDb. It has also grossed a total of $138.7 million to this date with a budget of $129 million. So this movie has been certified fresh.
That's it for this week, folks. Now back to y'all.
With your gamer review is Noah Treviño.
Good Friday, Longhorns. I'm Noah, and welcome back to the gamer review. Today I'll be reviewing Jump Force, so let's jump into it. Jump Force was one of the most anticipated games of 2019 and had a lot of potential, but after playing it, I said to myself, what did I just play? This game feels like it's unfinished and wasn't meant to be released just yet. The story mode is the worst. The story feels weird at times and doesn't make sense. The characters look stiff and lifeless in the cutscenes, and most of the boss fights are just meh. However, the roster of fighters is great, with characters from Dragon Ball Z, Naruto, One Piece, Bleach, Yu-Gi-Oh! And many more to play as is overwhelming, and the combat and gameplay is fun and enjoyable, but can feel repetitive at times. With all that said, I give Jump Force a 6 out of 10. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next week. Now back to you.
With our all-new shout-out segment is Magali Gallagher.
I'm Magali Gallagher, and I will be your shout-out anchor for this semester. This week, we would like to shout-out ICFX for all his nice edits and highlight videos. You can follow him on Instagram at ICFX. We would also like to shout-out our own UTV sponsor, Mr. Cantu, for all his hard work here at UTV and Longhorn Radio. Thank you for everything you have taught us throughout this school year. Remember, if you would like to highlight anything or anyone on our UHS campus, you can contact us on Instagram, Twitter, or Snap at Longhorn Radio. That's it for this week. Now back to you.
Time right behind my back.
We hope you enjoyed this week's show, and don't forget you can check us out on Instagram, Twitter, and Snap at Longhorn Radio. We hope you have a great weekend. This has been What's Happening Around Longhorn Nation. We'll update you more on next week's show. See you next time, Longhorns.